Hey guys, Mr. Mac here. Happy Monday. Hope you guys all had a great weekend. Today is going to be kind of short. Today, I just want to quickly kind of review. Hopefully you guys had a chance to watch the video on spread yesterday. And hopefully you guys understood it. It's pretty simple. So I'm going to go over a couple of the key points of those videos today. And I'll give you a little bit of an assignment to do tonight for tomorrow. Okay, so let me fix the windows here and we'll get started. All right, there we go. All right. Oh, by the way, guys, don't forget, every time at the beginning of all my videos, I'm always giving you hints about a popular movie. So if you can guess what movie the music is from, or maybe my desktop background is from, put that in the comments section, kind of like a little game, so you can figure out what movie was today's theme. So let's talk about spread. So before we were talking about measures of center, mean, median, and mode, that really looked at exactly what it says, looking at ways to identify characteristics about the center of our data. Now we're looking at spread, and spread really is talking about distance between one point of data and another point of data, so how far apart certain points are from each other, which is spread. So the key thing for spread, and the reason why we went over it, is box plots. Because if you guys remember, a box plot takes data and puts it in order from smallest to biggest, and then breaks down that data into four different parts. So you've got the lower 25%, and then the next 25%, and then the third 25%, and the fourth 25%. So that breaks down the data into different quarters, and based on those points along that data line, we can figure out the spread of certain things. So I'm going to show you an example here. So here's just some random data points, 2 through 13. So what is the range, the total range of this data? Well, the range is the distance between this point here and this point here. So 13 minus 2 would be 11. So the range of all of this data, the total range from the beginning to the last, is 11. Now, if you remember, how do we do or set up a box plot? Well, there are five things. If you guys want to go back to the video, you can check it out. But there are five points that we need to identify on this number line. The first two is easy. That's the beginning point and the end point. So for us, the beginning point here is 2. So I'll put a dot there on 2, and then 13. So there's a dot there on 13. The third point we need is the median. So what is the middle number that separates this group of numbers into two even parts? An even part on the left or the lower side, and then an equal part on the right or the higher side. So we look here, we have 11 numbers. So I'm going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So my sixth number is going to be 8. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on this side. So the 8 is going to be my median. It separates the numbers into even parts. I have 5 on the left and I have 5 on the right. So I'm going to put a dot on my number line for the median right there. Now I need to find quartile 1 and quartile 3. So basically what that is I do the same thing. I'm trying to find the middle number, kind of like a mini median, if you will, of the first half of the numbers. So remember, the 8 separates it into lower and upper half. So the quartile 1 is the middle number of this lower half here. So I've got 2, 3, 4, 4, and 5. So there's 5 numbers there. So this 4 right here is going to separate evenly into 2 on the left and 2 on the right. So my first quartile number is 4. So I'm going to put a point here at 4. And now I do the same for my third quartile number, which is the middle point of these 5 numbers here on the upper side. And obviously that's going to be 10. So my quartile 3 number is 10. So these are the 5 points that you need. You need the beginning, you need the end, then you need the middle of everything, like the median, the middle of the whole data set. Then quartile 1 is the median of the lower half of the numbers, and quartile 3 is the median of the upper half of the numbers. So you really got to find the median three times. The whole median, the middle of everything, and then the median of the first half of the numbers, median of the second half of the numbers. And this is what we end up with these 5 points on my number line. Now the box of the box plot are the 3 points in the center. So this 4, 8, and 9 here, these are my points that are going to make up my box. Ta-da! There's my box. I'm going to draw a line down through the median right here. And then I've got my whisker that goes to here, and I've got a whisker that goes to here. And that is my box plot. So here's the divisions. So from here to here is 25% of all the data numbers. From here to here is 25%. From here to here is 25%. And from here to here is 25%. So you can see how this box plot divides the data into four equal quarters. You got 25% of the points are here, 25% are in here, 25 here, and 25 here. The important part for us, and really what we're going to be looking at and trying to find, is what's called the interquartile range, or the IQR. And I'll write that down here. So the interquartile range. What is the interquartile range? Well, the IQR, the interquartile range, is basically the range of the box, meaning here the box starts at 4 and it stops here at 10. So what is the range between 4 and 10? Well, that's 6, right? Because 10 minus 4 equals 6. That is the interquartile range, and that's a pretty important number in spread. On the worksheet that I give you guys, you're going to be asked to find the interquartile range of some data sets. So that is 6. It's pretty easy. What does this interquartile range represent? Well, it's the middle 50%, right? Because from here to here is 25% of the numbers. And from here to here is 25% of the numbers. So added together, this is like the middle 50% of this data set right here, right? Let me give you another example. So here's an example of where these are quizzes are scores on a quiz, right? So I have 57 through 100. First of all, what is the range? The range, the total range of the data sets. Well, you're starting at 57 and it goes to 100. So 100 minus 57 is going to tell me the distance between here and here. That is going to be 43. So the range of my numbers is 43. From the very first number to the very last number, 43 spaces in between. Right. Now let's go ahead and make our box plot. So remember, I need the first, the last, the middle, the quartile 1, and quartile 3, which is the middle of the lower and the middle of the upper. So let's go ahead and do that. Well, obviously, I've got my first and last numbers right there, 57 and 100. So I'm going to go ahead and put a dot here on 57, and I'll put a dot here on 100. Easy enough. Now I need to find the median, the center point. So how many numbers do I have? I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I have 11 again. So I'm going to count up 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is my middle number here, 74, because that's going to give me 5 numbers here on the left and 5 numbers here on the right. So 74 is my median, my center point. Median. Let's go ahead and put a dot on 74. Now we need to find our quartile 1 and quartile 3. Well, again, that's finding the median again, but this time I'm only finding the median of this first half of numbers here, these 5. So the middle number here is going to be 61 because it divides it with 2 on the left and 2 on the right, right straight in the middle. So that is my Q1, my quartile 1. So I'm going to put a dot, let's go back to my blue pen here, on 61. And then, again, let's find quartile 3, which is the middle point of the second half of numbers here. and that would be 83. So that's Q3. And I'll go ahead and put a dot on 83, right about there. Now I can go ahead and make my box plot here. Remember, the three middle dots are your box. Here's my median. I always put a line for the median. My whisker one goes this way, and then I got one shorter one that goes this way. Okay? So now that I have all that information, I can answer any question that they might throw at me about spread. What is the range of the upper 25%? Let's take a look at that. Upper 25. What's the range? Well, it starts here at 83 and it goes to 100. So the range of that is 17, right? How about the lower 25? Okay. Well, it starts here and it ends here. So it goes from 57 to 61, which is only 4. Okay? Because guys, remember, the box plot divides it into quarters, even 25% quarters. So the lower 25% is there. The next 25% is here, from this line here to this line here. Then I've got the next 25% here from the median to the quartile 3, and then the final 25% here from the last part. What is the interquartile range of this? Well, the interquartile range is the range of the box from the beginning of the box to the end of the box. So this is 61 here, and it goes to 83. So from 61 to 83, the IQR, or the interquartile range, is going to be 22. Okay? So that's pretty much it for how to understand spread, or at least this part of it. The second part of spread is the standard deviation that we'll start going over on Wednesday. But for at least the first spread video, this pretty much kind of sums it up, which is kind of why it was important to learn about box plots before we started getting into this. Okay? Pretty simple. All right, so your assignment. Okay, so first of all, the district has been going back and forth with how to meet you guys online. At first, they wanted Google Meet. Then that wasn't working, and we went to Zoom. Now, they don't want us to use Zoom, so we're going to go back to Google Meet. So I'm going to be available on Google Meet tomorrow, Tuesday, from 12 to 1. And then again from 2 to 3. For anybody that wants to pop in and ask questions, you can go ahead and do that. And then we'll try to set up like a regular schedule with Google Meet. Also, not many people have turned in assignments from last week. Remember, I need you guys to take a picture with your cell phone of one of the two daily warm-ups and the mean, median, and mode worksheet, and go ahead and email those photos to me so that I can count that for a grade. Also, don't forget to comment on this video, because that's how I take your daily attendance. All right? Your assignment, I am posting a worksheet in Google Classroom on spread. It's pretty easy. You can go ahead. It's a Word document. But you can, again, go ahead. You can answer the questions on a separate sheet of paper. You don't have to download the form or figure out how to do it online or that way. You can just do it on a separate sheet of paper, and that's completely fine. Okay? So Google Meet tomorrow from 12 to 1, 2 to 3. You've got a short little worksheet on what we just talked about today on Google Classroom. All right? Guys, have a great night, and we will see you tomorrow.